Hey everyone, just wanted to do a quick demo on how to convert your offline copy or mobile geodatabase to a file geodatabase and then also update your master incident geodatabase. So first things first, I have got a mock fire set up here in the training service. I'm in my edit map within my edit project, and using the training service, I've already synced up my edits after they were complete, so it should be good to go. Next thing is to convert that mobile to a file geodatabase. So we need to find that geoprocessing tool. We can do that under the Analysis tab and then click on Tools. That'll open the geoprocessing pane. All you need to do is type in mobile in the search bar, and it should be the first one that pops up, mobile geodatabase to file geodatabase. So select that one. And we've got an input mobile and an output file geodatabase. If you click on the browse folder there, it'll open up the window. Now, since I'll be using OneDrive in this case, I've opted to save my mobile or offline copy to my local C drive. So I've also created a workspace folder and a specific fire folder for this. And all I need to do then is select my mobile geodatabase. If you're on an active incident, you won't see the training prefix here. It'll just be GISS edit. So select that one, hit OK. And the next step is to select your output file geodatabase. Now, within your project, you want to go to your folders, your home folder here. In this case, 2022 lava, select that, go to incident data, and then into your backups. So that's where we're going to store all of our backups. And from there, the next step will be to convert that backup and replace our master. So since this was yesterday's, I'm going to go ahead and create a new item, a new folder, 2022, February 24th. Double click in there. Now we want to use GeoOps file naming conventions. I just so happen to have the GeoOps file namer up and filled out, you can see, for this particular fire. And so all I need to do is scroll down to the backup for the master incident geodatabase. And all I need to do, that's the proper naming. So I'm going to copy that, minimize my file namer. And then I'm just going to paste that name right in there. And you can see it's got the date and time. Should be good to go. So save that. Hit the run button here. And this does take a little bit, but not too long. It's usually about 30 seconds to a minute, depending on how big your data set is. And there it is. So once we're complete, the next step is to use that backup to actually replace your master incident database. So now we've got our backups all set. We're good there. Now we just need to swap this out and replace that master. Okay, I'm going to do a refresh on this because it looks like we got some dual names there. All right, so this is what your home folder for your incident should look like. Now, where we saved that was in incident data in the backups folder for, in this case, February 24th. And there it is. There's our backup geodatabase. So we know that that's there. The next step is to copy this geodatabase, then right click and hit copy. And what we want now, I'm going to close the backups. We want to paste that into our incident data. You can see here that we've got other incident geodatabase. We've got annotation, progression, and then this event geodatabase. That's our master geodatabase. That's what we use for mapping. So I'm going to paste my backup, a copy of my backup, into the incident data folder. And you can see now that we've got that backup pasted here with the date and time. What we want to do is essentially remove our old master and rename this. So there's two ways to do that. You can either go ahead and delete that right away. and then just rename it. What I like to do is soft click on our master or event geodatabase, and then I'm just going to do a control C to copy that exact name. That way there's no mistakes. And then I'm going to click outside of there, and I'm just going to go ahead and delete that old master. And yes, we do want to permanently delete that. And now what I can do in the replacement or the updated geodatabase, soft click in there and then just hit control V to paste that exact name. And that is our new master geodatabase. Now, when we get out of our editing project, we are good to go with all of our mapping projects, and they will all be pointed to the new updated Master Incident Geodatabase. Thanks.